videos, especially to my brothers, and also other members of the family. Why the wake up now? Why the wake up now? You know, my whole life I've already known my status of royal, and yet not able to have it or obtain it because of there's no economy that I can go with in the bring. Not have the answer to give the people, not the answer. If there is no answer, it is like showing up to a party that is already going on and you're just another in the mix with a name. What's the point of it? If you do not make a change, then you're just merely another name on the list. Another name forgotten. I am quite a celebritaire in wanting to be remembered. For many years, thousands of years. Alright, so, there are my brothers. I have these three great, wonderful brothers. Now, unfortunately, they're older now, but they're not that old. Just stay away from the alcohol, as usual. Just please stay away from the alcohol. And then everything will be fine. It is not good for our particular bloodline. We are a short Basquignon. Descent from the kings there of the upper Pyrenees in Spain, also. So it's not great. It's not a great line to just start taking alcohol into. We are smaller people. One drink for us is not the same as a drink for another. So yes, we are quite feisty. We are quite feisty persons. And fighty in that realm. And that does not mean we are always correct, that's for sure. It does not mean we are always correct. It does not mean that we do not come off our high horse of feisty either. But we are very argumentative. And I really believe the reason so is because we've had this coursing through our veins, all of these things as we have to do. All of these global changes have been coursing through our veins our entire lives, and so they give additional, oh my gosh, additional strain. And so then there's a run for maybe a drink of alcohol. Oh my gosh, block all of my brothers from that purchase at the store right now. I do not want them taking one more ounce of tequila, nothing, not a beer. We need clear heads here. We are talking about a global communion of countries all over the planet in agreement, trying to stop all this ridiculous Iran having nuclear facilities, trying to stop Iraq from having a further civil wars, trying to stop wars from the Middle East prepositing further upon American territories, trying to stop wars from the Middle East continuing into Europe. This is a devastating moment right now in history. We are looking at gasoline, we're looking at benzol from the very beginning. Its ownership over the people. The push to put it in their cars. The ownership because it is making the faster train. The claim of that ownership is always going to be their specific spots it is found. And as energy has become renewed and wonderful, well, great for it. We have to also go back and compensate those rulers who have been the finders of the oil. I hate to say it, but we cannot turn our backs on them. They have been the ones that have brought us to this point, anyway. This overpopulated, pretty much, a lot of persons are saying hell. So we have a lot of hate towards those companies and those persons and those countries that are running them. But that is not necessary. It's not necessary. In the other, as these other energetic sources are coming alive, we do the opposite. We raise that price of oil. We raise that price of gasoline. We want the acceptance of the others. We want the acceptance of the electric a vehicle. We need these acceptances more and more. And if it is such a disruption that we have electric vehicles having their own specific days to travel on highways, or specific hours. We can have specific hours in the morning or specific hours in the afternoon. I was thinking perhaps 10 to 11 in the morning would be good for the electric cars only, and the other cars would have to stay out. But it gets difficult, doesn't it? It's almost better. It's almost better to have a specific day that is electric car day. I understand that the slower ones are the slower ones. And that's caused a little bit of aggression and stopping people from purchasing them. I believe more people will purchase them if we are here stating and mandating they have a specific few days of travel, that they are not going to be pushed by some benzoil behind them. Because that is quite an anxiety for a driver. All right, so as this is going on, then the increase of this is expected from Saudi Kingdom. I'm expecting this from British petroleum also. I am expecting them to raise and increase the price. Because it's not something that we want to take every ounce from the planet. It is not a necessary need to take every bit of oil, crude, and process it. It is not ever a desire to go and say, hey, we're at peak, and everybody, now we're dropping from the peak, and now they were pretty much the lowest ever. That is not a desire to even enter into that map, into that statistical game. The desire is to keep it there in the ground and not touch it. And if we do have to touch it, if we do have to convert it into oils, into benzols, then it is converted into these gas oils, expensive. So the purchaser is looking then at the cars and going, well, I think I'll take the electric car, and for 3 days a week is electric car day. And then those will be my days of travel to work. And that is a good life. The other ones are purchasing the expensive vehicles still. Expensive vehicles. And they'll have to pay expensive price for the gasoline as the conversions go. So this is our major economic fight right now, is the car companies themselves do not want to give up the old fast. And I believe that's just simply because of customer wants. Customers want to be on the road at a successful rate of travel with the others. They will always purchase the faster car if they can, because it is dangerous. It feels dangerous to have an electric vehicle that is going so slow. So we need to give electric vehicles their own days of travel, where they are not in any kind of a hampering of push from behind. So they can relax there on the highway. So this is how we get a further clean air. If you are all happy to live with yellow planet air, it turns dingier and then turns darker to darker yellow. It is remnant of bloody urine raining from the sky. Well, then there is something wrong with you. There is something wrong with you as an individual that accepts this. This is a time that we have got to change immediately. This is not up for negotiations. So economically, the companies that are containing oil right now will be compensated. They will receive further income to make up for what is not being purchased. So, one person has the electric car, not purchasing the oil, the other is a loss. They're looking at it as a loss, and so they will have to increase double to that supply. For each electric car that goes online, they will have to increase the cost. So we need these numbers. We need these numbers statistically given to the oil companies directly, and we have to mandate specific days for electric. I know I went off and I said that we need a specific days for motorcycle also. That may be a luxury, and perhaps it's not as I don't know. I really would maybe just one day. Come on, one day for the motorcycles only. But I am definitely knowing economically, it is the best sense to adaptation into the future, into what is now already presently available, and not to have to endorse stupidities. I didn't want to talk about my television filled with porno. Oh my gosh, in this house has a television. I turn it on and it's pornography immediately. And the atrocity to my eyes to see these gaggling women and their buttocks in my face is so crude that it is unbelievable. It's unbelievable how much is just being supplied. I have free pornography on my television. So no, I don't turn on my television. And this was offered by the persons who initially rented this house. What a bunch of weirdos. What a bunch of weirdos. Oh my gosh. I understand, you know, for your own personal, but not from the landlord. That is bizarre. So in the wake up of all of this, I'm like, wait a minute, I'm not to be landlorded at all. I really am the royal here. I'm a royal. You know, it's not a royal ballet, you know. I am the monarch. I'm the monarch of France. And so there's the answer. There's the answer in the equivocation, in the switching. So we have the one electric car and the compensation in the price revaluation of the oil companies. They need to have, so let's say the price is at 3.58 crude a barrel. Another 10,000 electric cars are sold. Their price goes up to 4.58 a barrel. So we do it like this. We figure out that amount, all right? So that is a fair and just system. And so they're not going to be put at any kind of anxiety that they're going to go out of business anytime soon. Because often those businesses are the suppliers of their populations. They are the suppliers of what is feeding the people and giving them a good life. So this is not my injunction to push electric cars, so much so that it keeps the oil companies out of supplying a decent life for their people. I don't know. I want to talk of other things. I want to speak about this. Speak about my brothers and the shock. Yes, it is a shock. It's a shock to find out all of these things and genealogy, and it just keeps smacking me in the face again and again that I am too much a monarch, and too much of this, and it's just like, well, no wonder I've been such this in my life, you know, such I'll say an Auslander. Such an Auslander, even in my own particular birth country. I have not even been living there, really. It has not been a place I've understood. I've had so many things, heady, other, that I have to live in counterance with and containment with. I already know. That they've hidden it, the three brothers have hidden it with a beer. Or they've taken a drink from some kind of a lemon drop, or a glass of wine, you know, a glass of wine extra. Almost to numb what? That you do not have an economic plan? It's true. It's a very difficult. It's a difficult trajectory to even enter into, even for a moment, even dabble into want of it. Nobody wants this position of monarchy. It is absolutely awful. It has been. It's giving a military to you immediately to make decisions for. Nobody wants this particular position. It is extremely stressful. This is not a four-year presidency. This is extremely stressful. It is the rest of your life until your deathbed. So yeah, so there is alcohol, and so there it is, you know, the numb of it. Any store shopkeepers, if they are dare to go shopping for it for 1 minute more, block them. Block them from that stupidity. Any bars that are there in the Bay Area, if that's where they are right now, I don't know. They may be in Mallorca. I have no idea where they are right now. They're not contacting me. My family is in kind of a serious situation, aside from the escape. They're trying to escape, you know. They're trying to escape from. Trying to escape from, because you do not have all the answers. No man is going to have all the answers for the entire world, and no woman either. So you need to relax with that and not run to the drink for a numbing, because you do not have all the answers. This is not about bringing alcoholism into the monarchy. This is about bringing clear heads. So just clear your brains out. I don't mean clear your brains out, but yeah, clear the asphyxiation want of it ever. It's not a requirement. You're much better than that, and you already know this. So, when I'm now thinking, I got lost in. Oh yeah, they live often in the meanderings of small mind activities, that they are just a business. They just opened up a business, and they work their business, and they pay their mortgage. So when they're working in these small mines, it's because for some reason they have been hit hard. They have been hit hard that they are worthless, and their self-esteem is that low. That they are merely just another business operator. Rather than leaders of this planet. So, businesses can be bought and sold, and they can be replaced with new partners easily. Just put somebody else in charge. You know, you don't have to run that business. Name has changed, you know, the name has changed on the business. It's no big deal. There's a planet to run. Now, if we have this monarchy that we have to run now through Skype, I have to run through this YouTube video sessions. If this is the way we have to run the planet because of safety, well, then this is a truth also. My particular family has had these two helicopter crashes in the recent times, both within, I believe it was one summer. Two husbands. Of my cousins were killed in the helicopter crashes. So my cousins' husbands were killed. Other men also, I believe they were all men on the one helicopter. It was a large carrier type. I believe there were possibly up to 10 people that were killed. I understand this is still with Fort Bliss because they were military helicopters. This is still with Fort. One was, I believe, private, and the other was military. I believe Fort Bliss is still trying to figure out why, how it happened, and why the reason. Foul equipment is one, but yet the families of all of the people that died on the helicopter. Are curious as to foul equipment is very unusual. I already know the pre-flight checks. I already know how intensified they are. It's extremely unusual. So the faulty equipment would have been damaged or sabotaged on purpose. So the people on those helicopters were brought to their death. Now, so this is an odd, it's not really an assassination attempt direct to my family. However, to the husbands. So it is an odd, strange hurt, isn't it? To my female cousins there. They're newly married husbands. So there's reticence for my brothers to enter into politics. But you cannot, you don't even have a choice. You don't have a choice. As monarchy, you are born as. You don't have the choice. It's not like a scepter that you can just pick up, like as a little queen bee fancier at the moment. You are born as thus. You are either a good ruler or you're a bad one. If you want to remain a bad ruler and live in some hideaway underneath another drink of alcohol or an extra glass of wine, then you are a bad ruler. And you will not be remembered for anything but that. So what is your objective in this life to be on your epitaph? What is your objective? To wake up and smell the coffee? To realize that you are a global economic? To realize that the coffee, even that, has to be thought of? How much coffee is coming in from South America and Mexico into Europe? How much is being imported? How much is being imported from Africa right now? That devastant. That war right now, there's a coffee war going on. So is the savannas, is the deserts of Africa, is the, what do we call those the young, they have the forest zones also. They are being swept away for a coffee. To replace Mexico, to replace the South American brews. And as Britain becomes more and more equipped to wanting a cup of coffee instead of tea, we are ending up with a coffee war. And so we have economic disability that goes immediately to Mexico. It goes immediately to South America, but more and more Africa comes online, just because the shipping routes channels are different economically. No. Cheaper. Africa will always be the cheaper. Mexico cannot be as cheap as Africa, bringing the coffee to Britain or to France. Or to other European areas. Yeah, we used to drink other things. It was not just this coffee. It was not just this tea. My gosh. We used to drink other things, didn't we? But now these coffees and teas are certainly ruling the world, aren't they? You don't pay the tax. And way back then, you know, the Revolutionary War began. Right there with Britain. That was all it was. That was all America was about right then and there, was they did not want to pay the tax to the Queen of Britain for tea that was imported from India. That was the only reason America became different. They did not want to pay the tax back to the Queen in Great Britain. So there's a lesson there for the history. I guess that one's for my younger brother. I don't believe he was listening that day. So anyway, what? So I'm looking at the global medium here, and this is how I communicate, this is how we have to communicate, is on this YouTube. I realize I have been pretty much kept as a prisoner here, but yet I accept it, because the wake up to this monarchy is a madness. It is a madness to even have to endeavor into the rule of its meanings, of what it is. It's just a madness to have to venture into the all of the economy and fixing it. And yet it has to exist. Or we end up very, very quickly, in a technological disaster. So that's my amend. I'm trying to amend technological disaster. All the banks are run on the digital. All the banks are run through this. And so I've made these amends for all of a sudden, if you have a land or a country and there is no electricity, instead of going into civil war and anybody who has the guns grabbed, there it is. I have given these answers. I have given these answers to amend so you do not have, people running mayhem and amok. And have some kind of a decency during those situations. I don't know. I presume in immediacy is like there is a denial stage my brothers have gone through, and yet maybe not. There is never a denial. It was merely the how to actually, you know, make this understanding clear that there would be something to bring to the people also aside from just another ruler. What's the point of just another ruler? It has to be a major change. So the profit share, like I said, the profit share solves every problem with, but I have to pay my mortgage. You know, these people that are yelling, they have to pay their mortgage. The profit share to those employees that are worried they're not going to make up the difference from the 20,000, it's all working. And I understand it's a slow process. It's not going to be immediate. And this is another problem. I cannot just say I turn off the key of the old and start with the new. We're not building this kingdom based upon false money, based upon false accounts, based upon a loan that a bank that has $100 million in property loans and sells them to another bank for another price, and so he pays of some kind of an interest fee. This is not going on. That's all it is. That's all the property market is a pass the loan around. You know, from your little 100,000 house, it goes to the bank of a group of 100 million of those, and so that bank has somehow fessed up to some collateral that says, okay, I'll pay the interest on the 100 million. You know what I mean? So the money goes on and on and on. So that bank, the first bank that gave you the loan for the 100,000, never had the money to give it to you at all. It was merely a collateral haul, a haul of paper, of passing the interest on to a higher bank. So it's a pretty desperate system, actually. It's a pretty desperate system. It's a very dangerous system. It's one that can collapse at any moment from one bank to another. So the premise of the Vaux kingdom here is specifically to stop that and have a real budget from the real properties. So I've written out there on the blog, it is going to be what is sold, each property sold has a buyer. And those are the ones that we accept immediately into the kingdom as a certified deed of writ, a writ of own. And we'll accept those as writ of own deeds certified and handle their paperwork. Now there is not going to be anything else but those for a while. We have to stir the vat only with those because that is where the income is being earned directly from those buyers and sellers. And that is full price. That is full price. That is not coming in from a loan at all. So if you have your house at the $300,000 for sale and someone purchased it for $300,000, that is $300,000 in full from their bank account. That is not a mortgage. That is not anything that is payable over a specific longer term time frame. It is paid at that moment, all of it. Then we start to have a stabilized real economy with real actual money instead of pretend paper. So it is an economy that is based exactly on existence, money being there, the truth of what is in the account. All right, so yeah, there's lots of things. There's lots of things I've written recently about. Yes, everybody wants the demand already. Give me the 20,000 each year. But in the beginning, it will be as Liechtenstein, as I believe Luxembourg was also beginning as. A lot of the Monaco, you pay to live there. You gain the citizenship, and then you get the 20,000 a year for the rest of your life. So that is the way it begins. To be a member of the kingdom, of the economic side of it. And in the interim, you remain the economic side of the other. When our balance is high enough, when we have enough income, then we can give you the loan out. Then we can absolutely. Then it will be. It's not a loan. It's because it is zero rated. Absolutely. Then you can, for each property sold, the persons will be able to purchase it for like 8,000 a year over 20 years time out of the 20,000, but not until that time frame, not until we have a high enough amount in that savings account, because it's a real money system rather than a false. All right. What else was I going to speak of? I don't know. I have a lot of... And it still supports the banks. It still supports the banks working and not collapsing or folding right away. So it is a cordial. It's very cordial with the current banks because anyone who does become a citizen of our particular kingdom immediately from the property buy and sell at full price... property sell and buy at full price, they will be able to use their 20,000 part of it to go toward a loan at any bank in the world. So I'm not canceling banks in the world either. They're quite able to continue. So the faster we build that particular profit into the kingdom savings account, the more and more people we can add into receiving the 20,000 yearly. And then there, and then there. Still, the banks will be, in many cases, compensated. So it is not a destruction of the banks at all. So I do not have the banks as my enemy at all. In the very beginning, I believe also the purchases will be smaller, such as apartments and condominiums, because with a little bit of savings you already have, and maybe two or three of you, you can already buy a condominium. So if you are a citizen, you'll be able to do this on the 1 year basis also. But if you want to buy a heady property like 300,000, no, you would have to have quite a bit of savings, and then you would also have to have additional persons, because that would only be for three people on a 300,000 property. That would only be 30,000 that you would get to put toward it. I will not allow any more until we have a large enough bank balance. So you could put the 30,000, and then you could put maybe the rest, the 270, from savings. So that is a difficult one. So I foresee already most of it in the very beginning will be smaller properties, which is a good thing. It's always a good thing to get those purchased. So it's not stopping. It's not stopping any property collections of when I see property collectors, no, it's not going to stop that group. It's not going to stop it. It's not going to stop the property from going up at all. I originally did want to redo it and put it at the four times, and but that's me thinking ahead. That's me thinking years and years ahead. And I believe that's what I've done. I went too far in the future of it. After it's all, the world has it, then we can reduce it all to four times a value. But right now, it's not the whole world. So I have to go with the contingency of you have to have the full amount as a purchaser for a property. And I believe it's there. I believe that you take the East Bay right now, I believe enough people have the full amount to purchase those properties. You can go from Berkeley all the way down into San Jose. Every single one of those properties can be purchased at full price that the asker is asking, out of personable savings accounts. That will fund the kingdom immediately. Those persons will gain instant citizenship. Hopefully already be supporting many of the people there by their one house, by the one house, one house, 500,000, say, one house. I did the math really great. No, let's say 4 million. So 4 million in houses sold ends up being 1 million into the king's savings account. Now that 1 million then it translates later on to about 25 people. It supports 25 people in 1 year to receive the 20,000. And it also gives the extra 500,000 towards other governments' costs. So one group of 4 million in purchases and sales give 1 million already to the king's the kingdom savings, and that 25, and then that gives 25 people already $20,000 a year. So it is the economic change instant, there for many people. So we just have to remember this that it has it has so much. It's just the transition phase. And if it's that we have to be the kingdom that builds this slowly, then we have to be the kingdom that builds this slowly. So that's the way it goes. I think that's understandable though. But yeah, that's a greatness. 25 people. 4 million in house purchases and sales, at outright costs paid. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. And how many? I'm saying it's in the gazillion already there. Probably no. It's probably in the trillions, that region, you know, on a yearly basis. So that's what we're looking at, is already starting with that $1 trillion at least, quite quickly. So it's a transfer shift that has to occur. Otherwise, and then, you know, that is an economic change that is beautiful. And that's what this is all about, is trying to bring poverty away permanently and house everyone. And also, anybody who does purchase these properties at their outright savings will have renters. I would like to do that also, you know, give one, I could do that, one citizenship or renter to each property purchaser. You know, so they pay the 300,000, they pay the 800,000, they pay the 1.5 million. Then they have a renter. They have, we could do that. Give one renter citizenship to each house purchased. So that would not be a bad idea either. And so you'll already be getting somebody who is in a lesser predicament. You'll already be giving them a better life. So that would be, and yes, let's snap up all of those little apartments also. That would be wonderful. And with that would be a renter that is always going to pay the rent for the rest of their life, if you want. A renter who is always going to pay the rent. So it is at no risk. It is a great system as a person who is owning property, because they will always have their yearly income available to pay the rent. So, I don't know. I know, I get hyped for it. I get hyped for this, but I know. Just what, you know, just back to my brothers, you know, just take the monarchy as a regular. Get on your suit or whatever. Get on your suit and go shake hands with the King of Denmark and the royal family of Sweden. Go ahead and put on your shiny shoes and do all of this also. But I don't know. I just think it's better to have the economy in your pocket also as a methodology.